Eddie'sMarket.com. They're open 7 days a week at the heart of Charles Village. Show your Hopkins ID for a discount at Eddie's Market. Under Armour is proud to outfit Johns Hopkins Athletics in the world's most innovative footwear, uniforms, and training gear. Visit UA.com today to see Under Armour's full range of performance gear. They're back. Smoothie King Pumpkin Smoothies made with organic pumpkin. Four guilt-free, delicious flavors, all low-calorie. It's pumpkin pie in a cup. Stop by Smoothie King at 400 West Cold Spring Lane at 1209 North Charles Street and get yours. Proud sponsor of Johns Hopkins Athletics. Miss Shirley's Cafe is a locally owned, award-winning restaurant serving Southern specialties for breakfast, brunch, and lunch. Located in Rowan Park, only a short drive from the Johns Hopkins campus, or visit their locations in Baltimore's Inner Harbor and Annapolis. Voted Maryland's favorite restaurant and proud supporter of Johns Hopkins Athletics, Miss Shirley's.com. Travelstead Transportation Group, a full-service moving and logistics company, provides exceptional white-glove service you would expect to be offered in your own home or business. Give them a call at 443-708-3700 or visit them online at travelsaidgroup.com. Dick's Sporting Goods is proud to be the official sporting goods retailer of the 2019 Johns Hopkins University Athletics Program. Visit one of their locations in either White Marsh, Hunt Valley, or Glen Burnie. And remember, every season starts at Dick's. Rowan Park Place is Baltimore City's only continuing care retirement community. Apartments are available for individuals or couples over the age of 60 who are looking for an active and engaged lifestyle. Learn more at rowanparkplace.org. Sam's Canterbury Cafe, the neighborhood go-to spot for all-day breakfast, lunch, and weekend brunch. Named the best breakfast spot by Baltimore Magazine in 2018, Sam's features Zeke's Coffee, free Wi-Fi, and an outdoor terrace. Sam's Canterbury Cafe at the corner of Canterbury and 39th Street. Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to historic Homewood Field for Centennial Conference Field Hockey. Today's game features the Red Devils of Dickinson College and your mighty Johns Hopkins University Blue Jays. Here are today's starting lineups, beginning with the Red Devils. A junior attacker from Boiling Springs, Pennsylvania, number one, Maddie Dombowski. Junior attacker from Denver, Colorado, number four, Emma Godfrey. Senior midfielder from Ortona, Pennsylvania, number seven, Olivia Young. Senior attacker from Mount Laurel, New Jersey, number eight, Mia Scott. Sophomore defender from Hellertown, Pennsylvania, number 12, Ellie Werner. Junior midfielder from Springfield, Virginia, number 14, Marie Laverdier. Sophomore defender from Morgantown, Pennsylvania, number 16, Hannah Speary. Freshman defender from Katona, New York, number 17, Elise Harrington. Senior midfielder from Ann Arbor, Michigan, number 18, Jillian Beeman. Sophomore midfielder from Dorsyth, Pennsylvania, number 25, Sierra Bob. And in the goal, a senior from Baltimore, number 80, Heather Meter. Dickinson is coached by Carly Zinn, assisted by Amy McFarland and Jess Gray. And now the starting lineup for the Johns Hopkins Blue Jays. A junior midfielder from Lansdale, Pennsylvania, number four, Seema Sajjan. Sophomore midfielder from Louisville, Kentucky, number five, Abby Burke. Sophomore forward from Carrollton, Texas, number 10, Izzy Thompson. Freshman forward from Bethlehem, Pennsylvania, number 12, Sadie Abood. Junior midfielder from Newburyport, Massachusetts, number 13, Michaela Corby. Sophomore defender from Milford, Pennsylvania, number 18, Eileen Nichols. Senior midfielder from Phoenixville, Pennsylvania, number 20, Katie McAleen. Senior defender from Lansdale, Pennsylvania, number 21, Sophie Kim. Sophomore defender from Clifton, New Jersey, number 22, Sarah Mattias. Sophomore forward from Mechanicsburg, Pennsylvania, number 26, Maddie Brown Shearer. And in the goal for the Blue Jays, a sophomore from Avon, Ohio, number 99, Caitlin Hall. Blue Jays are coached by Jane Wells, assisted by Britt Walker, Merritt Davis, and Bill Pullen. The officials for today's game are Greg Vineyard and Karen Peterson. Ladies and gentlemen, will you now please rise for the playing of the Star Spangled Banner. Thank you.
5-5 and 2-2 in the Centennial has upset on its mind as Dickinson in the white, Hopkins in the blue, and the Red Devils will start with possession before it runs out and will go back over to Hop. Dickinson already has pulled a big upset earlier this week on Saturday. They trailed 2-0 early against ninth-ranked Ursinus. Three goals for this Dickinson team later in the game, and they win it 3-2 over a top-10 opponent, pulling off an upset at home. Now the Red Devils look for a big upset on the road. On the Hopkins side, again, looking to stay perfect in conference and keep that top-10 ranking. It'll be Michaela Corvey, who's been a big goal scorer as of late for Hopkins, as she had both goals in Hopkins' 2-1 win over Haverford on Saturday. There's Maddie Dombrowski, number one in white for Dickinson. Little give and go. She'll try and run it down, and the whistle gives it back to Hopkins. Now, Dombrowski, a junior forward out of Boiling Springs, Pennsylvania, normally number six, but she apparently, her jersey didn't make it on the bus trip here to Baltimore. So Dombrowski will be wearing number one today for Dickinson, but she's a big part of their offense. Two goals, two assists for the junior this year. And you'll see her on the ball a lot for the Red Devils. Up the near sideline, Katie Mackerlin comes up limping a bit, and the whistle's going to go against Dickinson. A lot of contact there from Jillian Beeman, number 18 in white. Here's Izzy Thompson up the left side. Hasn't quite gotten the goal scoring going to the level it was at last year. Thompson curls one inside the circle. It's loose in front. Maddie Brown Shear, and it's deflected in. Hopkins early takes a 1-0 lead just over 2 minutes into this one. And on really their best chance of the day, quickly take a 1-0 lead. It was all set up there by Izzy Thompson. She fed one in front. Brown Shear was close to getting the goal. Not sure if it took a deflection. Sadie Abood was in the area. But either way, a 1-0 Blue Jay lead. So quickly, Hopkins, a team that started slow on Saturday. And Maddie Brown Shear will get the goal. Abood did not get a touch on it. And for Maddie Brown Shear, the leading goal scorer, just continues her reign this season. 9 goals now for the sophomore to go along with 3 assists. But it was a nice play set up by Izzy Thompson as well. Hopkins on Saturday, they got the victory, 2-1 on the road against Haverford to go to 3-0 in Centennial Conference play, but it was not easy. The Fords got a goal in the 7th minute of that one to take a 1-0 lead, and Hopkins offense couldn't get anything going until finally, with less than 3 minutes to play, as that drive comes from outside the circle. So even though it finds the back of the cage, no goal, has to deflect off someone inside the circle. Although Hopkins couldn't get it going, at least finding the back of the cage, they broke through with less than 3 to play. Michaela Corvey got a goal to tie it. And then just a couple minutes later, in fact, with just 6 seconds remaining on the clock in regulation, Corvey scored again to give Hopkins a 2-1 road victory to get them to 8-2 overall on the season. So that became a huge moment for Michaela Corvey, who came into that game with 1 goal and got 2 in a span of a couple minutes right at the end to give Hopkins a huge road victory on Saturday. Whistle blows in favor of the Blue Jays here, and now they kind of flip the script, and it's been a lot of scoring for Hopkins, and well, it's really their last 10 minutes of game time. You see Abby Burke here to restart it. Now 3 goals. Of course, the 2 coming in the final 3 minutes on Saturday, and then they get one within the first 3 minutes today. So a 1-0 lead for the Blue Jays. Again, the sophomore, Maddie Brown Shear, gets her 9th goal of her sophomore season after she had 4 of them last year as a freshman. That's lifted up in the air, and Eileen Nichols will bring it down. You notice Nichols out there, number 18. She's making her first career start today. Nichols, a sophomore defender out of Milford, Pennsylvania. Just the seventh game she's appeared in this season, and just the ninth game she's appeared in her career. But a big moment for her is no Avery Seward in the lineup, her fellow sophomore defender. Of course, Seward has started every game back there for Hopkins. But she's not in there today. Instead, it's Nichols. So far, so good for her. This one rolls all the way into the circle. Sadie Abood makes a move to her right. Abood is in, and Abood scores. 2-0 now. The Hopkins lead as Sadie Abood gets her third goal of the season. Hopkins again dominating inside the circle. What a move from Abood to just curl around the defender, Hannah Speary, and put it to the far post past the goalkeeper, Heather Meter. And a two-goal Hopkins lead just over 5 minutes into this one. Of course, a situation that Dickinson is a little familiar with. They gave up the two goals to Ursinus in the first 10 minutes on Saturday, and then came back with three unanswered to pull the upset 3-2. Sophie Kim will get the assist, and for Sophie Kim, that's the first point of her career here at Hopkins for the senior out of Lansdale, Pennsylvania. Such a great career as the anchor of that back line, but finally she gets herself her first career point with the assist on that goal by Sadie Abood. Here's Katie Mackerlin in the midfield. So Dickinson surely has the firepower to come back. 22 minutes in on Saturday, trailing 2-0. They ended up with three goals as it all started with Jillian Beeman getting one. Then Mia Scott tied it 30 minutes in just before halftime. And then early in the second half, they got what proved to be the game winner from Elsie Harrington, which was her first career goal that was the biggest one of the season for the Red Devils. And now they start their comeback here, and they'll get the first penalty corner of the day. Caitlin Hall in goal, the sophomore goalkeeper, making her seventh start of the season, taking over for Jody Barris. And she'll be tested for the first time here. Hall in the six previous starts. She made 23 saves, eight goals have gotten past her. This is played to the top of the circle. She chipped on in, and Abby Burke is there to intercept. That was played well defensively by the Blue Jays. No real shot for Dickinson. Swept towards the circle. Here's Harrington. He rolls into the corner. And it'll stay on this end. Dickinson again, 5-5, 2-2 in the Centennial Conference. Under head coach Carly Zinn in her fourth season. She's had solid success in the three previous years, but hasn't gotten this team to the NCAA tournament yet. 33-31 overall record for Zinn in the three-plus seasons at the helm of this Red Devils program. And it's really a matchup of two fairly new head coaches to these programs. Jane Wells obviously has had some more success, but only her third season the helm of the Blue Jays. In the corner, Marie Laverdiere was down there. She lost it. Now Laverdiere recovers. Hopkins with a push, Michaela Corvey. And it goes back to Nichols. Eileen Nichols did play a good chunk against Haverford on Saturday. Played 24 minutes in that one, almost half the game, which is the longest she had appeared in a game this season, and now gets the start today. Seema Sugent. Three players surrounding her looking for the ball, and Sugent keeps it.
Sophomore attacker from Long Meadow, Massachusetts, number 10, Bridget Fontaine. A sophomore attacker from Owings Mills.
Couple subs coming in for the Red Devils as Bridget Fontaine enters.
Mountain Lakes, New Jersey,
along with a few others. Fight for this one down in the corner, and the whistle goes against Hopkins. A little too aggressive from Abby Burke. And now Sophie Kim just blocks it down to stop any breakaway. Hopkins ready to make its first sub in a few minutes here as number six, Danica Berman, is set to check in for Jane Wells' team. 2-0 Hopkins already in this one. Couple early goals. Maddie Brown-Shear got the first one. Sadie Abood got the second one as that one is popped up too high into the circle. Another whistle goes against Hopkins. Red Devils team already having more success really this year, at least in the win column overall, than they did last year. Went 6-12 last season, but they did go 5-5 in the Centennial. They really just had no success in the non-conference. This year, 5-5 overall, 2-2 in conference play. Down into the corner, and a whistle keeps it with Hopkins. About 5 minutes to play in this first quarter. 2-0 in favor of Hop as Fontaine tries to bring it down. But it's taken back by Sophie Kim. Tries to feed it to the opposite side of the field as Tessa Erickson just checking in. Saw that change on the fly as he tops into the bench. Tessa Erickson, the freshman forward, number two in there for Hopkins. Now Danica Berman's going to come in along with Bryn Rowland as some mass substitutions coming for the Blue Jays. Sam Chabot, number 29, in there as well. As Dickinson looking to answer back. That one swept across the face of goal. Harrington trying to run it down. She won't get there. And it'll go back to Hopkins. Now, Myra Granado, who started six games this year, comes off the bench here in this one. As Katie Mackerlin will get a break along with others. Wholesale changes from Jane Wells after her team takes the early 2-0 lead. Swept into the circle. Hits off a foot. And a corner coming for Dickinson. Second corner of the day for the Red Devils. They did not look very good on the first one. Couldn't really set up a shot at all. And Abby Burke just swooped in to intercept a pass and took it the other way for Hopkins. Here they'll try for their first shot of the day as they've seen this before, trailing early 2-0. Heading over to insert that corner, Amanda Fruman, sophomore forward at Owings Mills, Maryland. Fruman, number 13 in white, will sweep it in towards the top of the box. Fed over to the left side. Here's a shot. It deflects across the goal line, but it goes out of play. Dickinson that close from getting one back. Hopkins defenders holding their breath there as that ball just trickled right across the goal line but didn't have the angle to go in. And Dickinson with by far its best chance right there, but just missing out on goal number one. Here's Michaela Corvey with the intercept. Back to Myra Granado. That one bounces all the way through. Bryn Rowland tried to corral it. Now Sudgeon. Seema Sudgeon, her pass too strong. Looking for Granado. Maddie Brown-Shearer, Sadie Abood, each with goals in the first 6 minutes of this one to give Hopkins a 2-0 lead as Tessa Erickson takes that one away. Stole it right off the stick of Jillian Beeman. Erickson to Granado, able to keep it in play. And it'll stay with Hopkins. Pass for Sudgeon, hops over her stick. Now Danica Berman. Her pass splits two of her defenders, and Sophie Kim has to chase it back down on her side of the field. Nichols with a miss hit there, but Hopkins able to clean it up. Hopkins again coming off the 2-1 win over Haverford. This team has won 4 in a row. And they've put up some big-time goal-scoring numbers in those last 4 games. In the 4 victories, 3 of which have come against the Centennial Conference opponents. Hopkins combining for 19 goals in the 4 games, and they have allowed just 5 in those 4 victories. Of course, the big one, the 8-1 road victory a couple Saturdays ago against Washington College. And already the scoring continues. 2 goals in the first quarter here as we've got 60 seconds to play in this first period. Haven't lost since that 2-1 road loss to number 4 Salisbury back on September 18th. Hopkins 1-2 this season when facing ranked opponents. It's only 2 losses have come to fellow top 25 teams. Sudgeon making moves in the midfield. Under 30 seconds to play. See if Hopkins can make one more push to try and get a 3rd goal here in this first quarter, which flew by after Hopkins took an early lead. LaVerdiere with an interception, but she gives it right back to Nichols. Less than 5 seconds in the quarter. And that'll take us to the end of period number 1. Hopkins with a quick strike offense early. Just over 2 minutes in, Maddie Brown Shear got one. And then just over 5 minutes in, Sadie Abood added another. And after 15 minutes, it's Hopkins 2 and Dickinson nothing. We'll be back shortly for the second period here on Hop TV. Back here with you for the second quarter on Hop TV. Hopkins leading 2-0 in this one. Connor Newcomb with you here at Homewood Field. As it was two goals in the first 6 minutes of this one. Maddie Brown Shear got the first one. Sadie Abood got the second one for Hopkins. And they lead it 2-0 quickly in this one. And we got a whistle, and just about 15 seconds into this second quarter, Hopkins will get its first penalty corner of the day. Heather Meter, the goalkeeper, in there for Dickinson, wearing number 80, the senior out of Baltimore. So somewhat of a homecoming game for her, and she's already seen two shots go past her and still looking for her first save of the day. Burke will take out to Mackerlin. Mackerlin's shot deflected. It's loose in front, and it's swept in for goal number 3. Looked like Bryn Rowland got that one. Hopkins 3 and Dickinson 0. That one was loose in front for a little while, and it just fell right to the stick of Bryn Rowland, who swept it into an open goal. And Rowland gets her second goal here in her sophomore season. The Hopkins offense scoring early and often here in this one. Abby Burke gets the assist. She continues to put up the helpers this season. Now 11 assists for Burke to lead the team. And of course, Rowland, her second goal to go along with her 2 assists this year. Other goal came in the 8-1 just washing of Washington College a few weeks ago. So now 3 goals for Hopkins early in this one. They've started fast in both quarters so far. Of course, we talked about this Dickinson team. Went down 2-0 on Saturday against number 9 Ursinus. Came back with 3 unanswered to pull the upset win 3-2. Looks like it's going to be a different story today. Hopkins punched early, as Ursinus did against Dickinson, but they haven't let up at all. Getting a third goal to keep expanding the lead. Of course, you don't expect them to get 8 goals like they did against Washington College a few weeks ago, but the offense is clicking at a rate that it's still a possibility today. 3 shots for Hopkins and 3 goals. They've made the most of every single opportunity they've gotten so far. Here's Sophie Kim out of the back. See Avery Seward in the game. Again, she didn't get the start. First time this season she hasn't started, number 19 in blue, but sophomore Seward is back out there. Granado has it stolen. LaVerdiere into the circle. Dickinson a chance towards the goal line. Kicked away by Hall, and it now goes out wide of the goal. Emma Godfrey, number 4 in white, was trying to make that play happen. Junior out of Denver, Colorado. But her initial cross was deflected away by Caitlin Hall, who will pick up her first save right there, because that one was on goal. Hall with now 24 saves on the season. Fight for the ball right at that 20-yard line marker here at Homewood Field. And Hopkins thought they had won it, but the whistle gives it back to Dickinson. They'll play it quickly, and that one rolls on through. Elsie Harrington, who's kind of been everywhere for Dickinson, was almost on the receiving end of that on the far post. Harrington with 1 goal on the season, as she started this one for Dickinson. Now back-to-back starts for the freshman. That one's rolled in, and again, nobody there for Dickinson. The closest was Emma Godfrey. Sophie Kim on the restart. 3-0 for Hop. An early onslaught from the Blue Jays. Rolled up the field here. Makara Desai. And Desai loses it and has the whistle go the other way. Berman up the field. Now Bryn Rowland, who got goal number three, back to Berman. Tries to find Sadie Abood. Abood will deflect it off the foot of Olivia Young back there and gets her possession back. Abood into the circle. And it will be a corner for Hopkins. So nice run of play from the junior Sadie Abood, who got her third goal of the season earlier. And she earns another corner for the Blue Jays. Danica Berman will take for Hopkins. Rolls it up to Mackerlin, switches back to Abby Burke. Back out to Mackerlin now. She touched it along a little too far, though, and couldn't get a shot off. Katie Mackerlin, of course, having a great senior season so far. 5 goals for her, 2 assists. Looking to make it 4 years as an all-conference mention. First team last year, an honorable mention as a sophomore, and second team as a freshman. Whistle gives it to Hopkins. Danica Berman just bowling over a defender there as Olivia Young, the senior out of Ortona, Pennsylvania, again hit the deck. And it'll stay with Hop. They make a few more changes. The ball down in the opposite circle. Sarah Mattias comes back into the game. Anna Scott enters as well. Here's a giveaway. Floated in towards goal. Trying to get space to shoot is Burke, and Meter makes a nice kick save. Heather Meter with her first save of the day, her 53rd here in her senior season. But that was all set up by Abby Burke, who made a nice spinning move, and it just kicked off the toe of Meter, that close to a 4-0 Hopkins lead. Heather Meter again, a Baltimore native, played at NDP here in the area. It's Notre Dame Prep High School. She's played every minute this season as a senior in goal for the Red Devils. Into the circle here, another shot, and saved by Meter. She's got back-to-back stops. But a whistle blows in a corner for Hopkins. It's a little bit of a rough start for Meter. First 3 shots that she saw hit the back of the cage, but back-to-back saves now for the senior, who is really in her second season as the full-time starter for Dickinson. Started all 18 games last year, has played every minute this year, but did have 6 starts over her first 2 seasons as well. This corner played to Sarah Mattias. Try a backhanded shot, it's up in the air, and the whistle will give it the other way. That one's not going to get through this Hopkins midfield line. Here's Katie Mackerlin into Abby Burke. Ran a little too far for her as Hopkins making a bunch more subs here. And a lot of contact will cause another corner. And again, it's Sadie Abood down there making things happen for Hopkins offensively with less than 8 to play until the half. 3-0 Hop. Maddie Brown Shear, Sadie Abood, Bryn Rowland have the goals for the Blue Jays. Abby Burke will take this corner. Mattias and Mackerlin set up atop the circle. It'll play to Sarah Mattias. She'll try a shot, trying to loop it over the goalkeeper, Meter, who makes a nice save with the pad, kicks it away. Now another shot deflected and cleared away. Heather Meter in goal, starting to get into a groove here. You like the idea from Mattias there, but she got that big pad up there and made the stop as she was kind of backpedaling towards the cage. A Avery Seward got the stick up too high there, and it goes back to Dickinson. Seema Sudgeon will knock that one down. But a takeaway by Godfrey. Godfrey will run. She's got Dombrowski to her left. Instead, she'll sweep it all the way across. And she was trying to find Desai. Instead, Sudgeon comes onto it as Hopkins makes some changes. Sam Chabot, the freshman, lost it out of bounds. Here's Jillian Beeman, who has her pass deflected. And now Abood again. Abby Burke up to Abood. Taken away by Beeman. Jillian Beeman, first team All-Centennial Conference selection last year. Started all 18 games, had an assist. As Izzy Thompson will bring it the other way, but Hannah Speary able to take it off her stick. Dickinson has a couple all-conference performers on this team. Beeman and LaVerdiere both making the all-conference team last year. Corvey whips one, and it's deflected towards Granato, but she couldn't get her stick to it, as it was Beeman who knocked it down first. Now a ball up for Maddie Dombrowski. The junior forward up the right side. Working on Sarah Mattias. Dombrowski into the circle, sweeps one across, and it's knocked down. Swept in again. It's up in the air. Hall takes her foot to it, but a corner coming up here. On that initial cross there, it was Bailey Schwab who made the stop to thwart any chance for the Red Devils. It came back in, though, and then Hall got out there, but a corner coming. Emily Misick will take it, 22 in white. That one's a high hopper towards the top of the circle. Now Dombrowski. And another corner coming for Dickinson with under 5 to play until the half. It will be Emily Misick, the junior out of Norristown, Pennsylvania, who will take it again. She's got a goal and an assist on the season. Misick keeps this one lower to the turf. A shot from inside the circle, saved by Caitlin Hall. And another one is deflected out and cleared by Sudgeon. But Hall coming well off her line to stop that one. As Katie Mackerline comes back in for the Blue Jays. Sudgeon for Seward. That one's going to roll on through. Chabot picks it up. Mia Scott trying to fight for it. And Abby Burke with a little too much contact. Sudgeon can't quite get to it. Dickinson maybe with some numbers if they tried it, but instead we'll drop it back to Misick. These two teams have seen a lot of each other. 43rd all-time meeting. And the all-time series pretty close. Although this game has been all Hopkins. In the 42 previous meetings, 21 wins for Hop, 19 wins for Dickinson, and two ties between the two squads. Big run of play here for Hopkins. Deflected away by Meter. She got her foot to it. Taking no chances right there. The teams met last season, October 3rd, at Dickinson. It was a 3-1 Hopkins win in that game. Izzy Thompson, Seema Sudgeon each got goals. Sierra Bob had the only tally for Dickinson. And although the all-time series is pretty even, Hopkins has been better here at home. They've won 13 of the 20 matchups here in Baltimore. Mackerline contacted from behind. She'll keep the ball. Tried to find Thompson. Rolls through for Mackerline, but she couldn't keep it in. Brownshear, Abood, and Roland, the goal scorers for Hopkins, a 3-0 lead. Izzy Thompson, nice defensive play. She'll start the break. Thompson to her right. She'll keep it moving. Bailey Schwab. Now Burke. Abby Burke makes a nice move inside the circle here towards the goal line, and it just runs out of play. Maddie Brown-Shearer was trying to get onto it, but she will earn a penalty corner with less than 2 minutes to play in the first half. Burke will take it for Hopkins. Michaela Corvey up there, along with Mackerline. It rolls all the way over towards Brown-Shearer. Behind her, back to Mackerline. Shot deflected by Burke. What a pretty goal for the Blue Jays. Abby Burke, who just snuck in towards the goal line, gets her first goal of the day and her fourth of the season. But it all started with the behind-the-back pass from Brown-Shearer, and Mackerline with a perfect pass right to Abby Burke. One of the prettiest goals of the season from Hopkins, and the Blue Jays lead it 4-0 late in the first half.
Assisted by number 20, Katie Mackerline.
Again, Burke gets her fourth goal. Mackerline gets her third assist. And now the referees are talking, and they may be disallowing this goal. They're chatting with Mackerline. And it's obviously something about the stick of Abby Burke when she shot that one. And they're setting this up as if it's not going to be a goal for Hopkins. Katie Mackerline pleading her case here with the referee. As you see the replay again. And Abby Burke getting the goal. We didn't see a lot of complaint from Dickinson either, but take the goal off the board. It's going to be just 3-0 for Hopkins. So a goal that looks so good there is not going to count. Abby Burke won't get her fourth goal. Katie Mackerline won't get her third assist. And Hopkins won't get its fourth goal of the day. Instead, just 3-0 Blue Jays with 90 seconds remaining in the half. Here's Burke the other way. Trying to get the goal this time. Instead, she'll feed it off to her right. This shot blocked by Meter. It almost squeaks through, and then she's able to punch it away and get the whistle off the shot from Michaela Corvey. Trying to find out at the half why exactly that goal was disallowed. But still 3-0. Hopkins leads.
1 minute to play in the second quarter.
Under a minute to go in this first half. Obviously, in a 3 or 4-0 game, you'd still like the goal. Not as big as if that goal had broken a tie or tied it up or anything like that, but still, the execution on that goal, I mean, you have to think that was right off the practice field from Hopkins. Probably a combination that Jane Wells put in practice right there, with that exact combination of passes to fake out the defense with the Brown-Shearer behind-the-back pass and then just finding Abby Burke, who was sneaking her way towards the goal line, and it's tough to have that one disallowed. 10 seconds remaining in the half, and Hopkins won't be able to get that fourth goal. But they do get a third here in the second quarter. Bryn Rowland got it. And as we hit halftime here at Homewood Field, Hopkins ranked 10th in the country in complete control of this one. It's Blue Jays 3 and Red Devils 0 as we hit the half. We'll be back shortly for the second half of Centennial Field Hockey action here on Hop TV.
Tomorrow and tomorrow, when we can get.
Second half about to get underway from Homewood Field. Hopkins with a 3-0 lead over the Dickinson Red Devils. Connor Newcomb back here with you on Hop TV. And it was a dominant first half for the Blue Jays. Maddie Brown Shear, just over 2 minutes in, got the scoring started. Then Sadie Aboud, about 3 minutes later, made it 2-0. Then in the first 30 seconds of the second quarter, Bryn Rowland made it 3-0. Hopkins thought they had a beautiful goal at the end of the half that would have made it 4. It looked like it should have counted, but an Abby Burke goal was disallowed by the referees, and that took us to a 3-0 halftime score in this one between the 10th-ranked Blue Jays and the unranked 5-5 Dickinson Red Devils. That's where we stand here on a Wednesday afternoon in Baltimore. Here's Maddie Dombrowski. Tries to weave her way through the Hopkins defense and couldn't find any success, although Harrington makes a nice play from down on the turf to keep it alive. The possession here will stay with Dickinson. Emily Misick will restart it. Circling the ball. And now we'll lift it towards the sideline. Back towards Olivia Young. And her pass taken away. Hopkins will try to run here. Mackerlin plays it ahead. Maddie Brown-Shear. Brown-Shear into the circle. It's her on the goalkeeper. Turns back to her right. Tries to pass in front. And a couple defenders were there to knock it away. Only as far as Aboud, though. And Hopkins will earn a corner. You like the idea from Brown-Shear there to kind of pull the defense her way, then pass it across the goal. But maybe if she had shot that a little earlier when she was on the break, as soon as she got into the circle, maybe a better chance of scoring. But either way, Hopkins will get a good chance here. Abby Burke will take this corner about 2 minutes into the second half. To Katie Mackerlin. Mackerlin feeds it off to her left. Here's a shot, and it's knocked down in goal by Heather Meter. 4 saves now for Meter. She's got 56 on the season as she's played every minute in goal for the Red Devils, senior out of Baltimore. And despite the 3 goals by her, she's had a nice homecoming here at Homewood Field. And obviously, Meter in there has played every minute. Her backup, Sage Stevens, just a freshman. And another corner coming for Hopkins. So you obviously have to see for Dickinson next year. Stevens will be the returner. You'd think they'd be bringing in another goalie. You like to have at least 2 on the roster. But for right now, for Carly Zinn's team, she's got a senior with experience versus a true freshman, and that's really why Meter's played every single minute. Another corner for Hop. Burke plays it in. Sarah Mattias. Mattias rolls it back over to Burke. Towards the middle of the circle, she turns looking for a shot. And the whistle blows, and another corner coming up. Burke back to the opposite side to take it. Mackerlin. Mattias back to Mackerlin. She'll try the shot. It's deflected. Still loose in front. Brown-Shear whips it along. Doesn't get towards the goal line. And the whistle will blow and take it the other way. Dickinson, good defending on that stretch of 3 consecutive corners. And Hopkins comes away without a goal. That one will run all the way through and out to give it back to Hopkins. See Anna Scott there. Back into this one. As she'll give the restart. That one rolls on through, and here comes Sadie Aboud. Tessa Erickson now. Erickson towards the goal mouth, over towards Granado. She turns back towards the middle. There's Erickson again, and Erickson scores. Tessa Erickson, the freshman, gets her second goal of her career, and it's 4-0 Hop. It was Erickson who played the initial pass. Granado sent it right back, and a great follow-up from Tessa Erickson. Instead of watching her pass, she crashed the goal mouth there and got it right back for goal number 4 today for the Blue Jays. Erickson, the freshman out of Glen Ellyn, Illinois, gets again her second goal of the season to go along with one assist. And Myra Granado gets her first assist of the season, and in fact, first assist of the sophomore's career to go along with her one goal this year. And now finally, Hopkins does get that fourth goal, which they still think should be their fifth. That half ended, Jane Wells was not happy with the referee, and what we think rightfully so should have been a goal, but instead disallowed for what we think was that Abby Burke lifted her stick too high on that shot. That's at least what it looked like the referee's call was, but people on the Hopkins side did not agree with that one. By the way, Hopkins does get the fourth tally and opens up an even bigger lead here early in the third quarter. That pass stonewalled by Sarah Mattias. She's got some space to work here. Try and drive one down the sideline. Looking for Maddie Brown-Shearer. A double team here, and Hopkins will get the possession. A couple of sticks come together. Sadia Boot had her stick locked up there with Hannah Speary. Pass over for Erickson. Rolls through her stick, but she's able to pick it up. Into the middle here. Knocked away by Speary. And Hopkins will keep possession. That one almost stolen by Erickson. She makes a nice play. And couldn't keep the possession without a whistle. Now Dickinson may be a chance to break. But that was only if Sierra Bob could have gotten on that ball a little quicker. She struggled to corral it, and it ends up going back over to Hopkins. Erickson bumped off the ball and the whistle blows. And 4-0 Hop. Approaching the midway point of this third quarter. As Michaela Corvey, who had 2 goals in the 2-1 win over Haverford on Saturday, comes back into the game. Both goals coming in the final 3 minutes of that one. She scored the game winner with 6 seconds remaining to beat the Fords on the road. This will stay with Dickinson here as the Red Devils are looking for anything. Mia Scott rolls one in. It hops up too high on Sierra Bob, and it goes back to Hopkins. Five shots for Dickinson, 11 for Hop. Heather Meters made 6 saves in goal for Dickinson to even keep it this close at 4-0. Seniors really had a nice day in the cage. Caitlin Hall on the other side hasn't been tested too much. 5 shots, the 2 on goal she's made saves on today. Whistles continue to blow as LaVerdiere will restart it. She rolls one in towards Bob. Seema Sudgeon goes down and wins it back for her team. Giveaway. Harrington dishes it off. LaVerdiere, top of the circle, will try a shot. It's knocked down immediately. She tries again, and it's swept away. Nichols, Granado, and Corvey. Nice defending there at the top of the circle. Now Tessa Erickson will go the other way. Race for the ball is Abby Burke, able to keep it in. Flick it towards the middle of the field, and here comes Corvey. Corvey with a little bit of space. He's going to find Erickson, who's able to keep it in play. Back to Corvey. Patter pass deflected. Now Bob. That'll roll all the way back towards Caitlin Hall. She watches it towards the corner. Nana Scott makes a nice play. Sienna Urbanski checks in for the first time for Hopkins. Bryn Rowland, Sam Chabot also both set to come back in for the Blue Jays.
Number 16, Sienna Urbanski.
Now Hopkins can kind of just ride this one out with a 4-0 lead. Just over 20 minutes of game time remaining in this one. Sudgeon with the defending and earns the ball back for her team. Urbanski right into the game and right on the ball for Hopkins. Up to Bryn Rowland, who had goal number 3 today for the Blue Jays. That came in the first 30 seconds of the second quarter. That one's driven up the field, and yet again, miscommunication. Emily Misick couldn't find anybody on the other end of that pass. Bridget Fontaine is in the area along with Harrington.
The game for Dickinson, a freshman midfielder from Mountain Lakes, New Jersey, number 19, Makara Desai.
Obviously, this Hopkins program is really on the rise. The first Final Four in program history last year. Of course, beat Dickinson 3-1 last season. But the all-time series that we talked about, 42 games, again, 21 wins for Hopkins, 19 for Dickinson, and 2 ties coming into today. This should be win number 22 for Hop all-time over the Red Devils. But there was a time when Dickinson kind of dominated this series, and Hopkins has won the last 2, but Dickinson last beat Hopkins back in 2016. That's only 3 years ago. That was at Dickinson, and that was a 6-1 win for the Red Devils in that one. Obviously, before Jane Wells took over as head coach, her first season was 2017 here with the Blue Jays, but that was the last of 5 straight years that Dickinson had taken down Hopkins, and by pretty wide margins similar to that 6-1 score. So things have turned around in the last couple years under Coach Wells. And Dickinson has gone the other way a bit. 4th season for Carly Zinn and hasn't gotten her team to the NCAA tournament. But Hopkins continues that turn in this series with dominance today, up 4-0 late in the third quarter. Michaela Corvey has it back. Towards the circle, Corvey makes a nice move to her right, back to her left, and the whistle blows for a Hopkins corner. Corvey hasn't found the back of the cage today like she did twice on Saturday against Haverford, but she's making things happen. Seema Sudgeon will take the corner for Hopkins. She'll play short for Corvey. And the referee stopping the corner immediately. And they're going to do it again. And Sudgeon is going to have to go back to midfield, and Katie Mackerlin will take. And that moves Anna Scott to the top of the circle. Mackerlin, they'll play to Corvey anyway. She'll rip one towards the back post. And it just rolls out. She was looking for Sam Chabot, who was making a run towards that back side of the cage, but couldn't get her stick to it. Hopkins thinking it's should be their possession. Instead, the referee gives it to Dickinson here late in the third quarter. Maybe a break for the Red Devils here. Towards the circle. Knocked down, scooped out, and it'll go back to Hopkins. Scott takes it away momentarily. Now Bryn Rowland. Pass to Corvey. Michaela Corvey splits two defenders. She's got a lot of options ahead of her. Corvey will sweep one towards Thompson. It comes up and hits her up high. And that's not something you want to see there, is that one deflected off the foot of the goalkeeper, Heather Meter. And it looked like it came up and hit Izzy Thompson in the face. She'll be looked at immediately here, as a corner will be coming for Hopkins with 48 seconds to play in the third quarter. And Thompson will come off under her own power. And she'll be checked on the sideline as Maddie Brown Shear checks back in. Smile on her face, though, which is a good sign as she comes to the Hopkins bench. Seema Sudgeon will again take this corner. Hopkins looking to make it 5 goals on the day. Mackerlin, Corvey, Bryn Rowland all up there waiting to receive this pass. Here's Mackerlin. Mackerlin will try a shot, and it deflects on through wide of the goal. Meter was down to try and get a piece of that. She's got 6 saves today. Hopkins has done a nice job pressuring here. They've won it back, and they've won another corner. Just under 25 seconds on the clock. See if they try to employ that same play that got them what we thought was their 4th goal late in the first half, but turned out to be disallowed for reasons many on the Hopkins side do not agree with. But it was a pretty play, and see if they could use it again here. Sudgeon will enter it. Brown Shear, Mackerlin, Corvey at the top. It's Katie Mackerlin. She'll try a shot, deflected by Meter. Still loose. A lot of contact, and it'll go back to Dickinson. Quarter ticking down here in the third. Maybe one more chance. If Corvey inside the circle rolls it along, it's deflected, and Hopkins couldn't get that final shot off. Sienna Urbanski was in the area, but just whiffed on the shot. And that'll take us to the end of 3 quarters. Hopkins adds one more in the frame. Tessa Erickson getting her 2nd goal of the season. And with 15 minutes to play, Hopkins in full control, leading 4-0. Join us back here real quickly for the 4th quarter on Hop TV.
Your attention, please. Now in the goal for Dickinson, a freshman from Hanover, Pennsylvania, number 40, Sage Stevens.
Back at Homewood Field, start of the fourth quarter. Hopkins, a 4-0 lead over Dickinson. Connor Newcomb with you on Hop TV. Hopkins adding one goal in that third quarter. Early in the period from Tessa Erickson, making it 4-0 after they got two goals in the first quarter and one in the second here in this one. Hopkins getting everybody off the bench here in this final quarter. Christina Glazer, senior out of Charlotte, North Carolina, is in there, number 11 in blue. And Dickinson making an interesting change. They make a change in goal. So I mentioned earlier how the senior Heather Meter had played every minute this season in goal. And she played the first 45 minutes of this one, but that streak's going to end for her. The freshman at Hanover, Pennsylvania, number 40, Sage Stevens, is in goal for Dickinson. And she makes her collegiate debut. So Meter will not end up playing every minute this season for Dickinson. That one's rolled into the circle and a corner coming for Hop just over a minute into this fourth quarter. Danica Berman will enter this corner in there for Hopkins. Bryn Rowland, Abby Burke, Tessa Erickson, Sienna Urbanski waiting up top. But it's going to roll all the way on through for Mackerline. Over to Rowland. Lost it off her stick. A lot of contact. And another corner coming as it was Glazer who hit the deck. She was shoved down to the turf. Their corner coming from Berman. Here's Mackerline. She rips a shot. Hits up high off of Abby Burke. She comes away limping a bit, but no goal for her. Ellie Werner with a takeaway. Now a break for Dickinson, trying to get that first goal, but it's snuffed out by Bailey Schwab. Next up for this Hopkins team, they're back at home on Saturday as they kick off a triple header at Homewood Field here on Hop TV. Field hockey, women's soccer, men's soccer, 12:30, 3:30, and 6:30. And field hockey team will get it started at 12:30 on Saturday, October 12th. They'll take on Muhlenberg here at Homewood Field, another Centennial Conference matchup. As Hop, after this one today, will be 4-0 in the conference and look to get to 5-0 on Saturday. And then they hit the road, play McDaniel next Wednesday, and then back home against Swarthmore on Saturday the 19th, 5 o'clock start here at Homewood Field, and you can watch it right here on Hop TV. On the other side, the Red Devils also staying in conference play. They've also got a home game. Saturday at 1 o'clock, they take on Washington College. Emma Godfrey rolls one up the field for Maddie Dombrowski. Back towards Godfrey. Godfrey tips it in front of goal, but it's swept away. Katie Mackerline got there at the perfect time to keep Dickinson off the scoreboard. Now Hopkins trying to run it the other way as the sun starts to come out here at Homewood Field. Would have been overcast day before that.
Aaron game for Dickinson, a junior midfielder from Ocean City, New Jersey. Number three, Phoebe Prettyman.
Sure there, Phoebe Prettyman. Number three in white into the game. I believe one of the last Red Devils that hadn't come off the bench yet today. Rolled over to Claire Tabin, who's also in there. Senior out of Ridgefield, Connecticut. Just the second game she's played in this year. Number two in white has the ball right now for Dickinson. Here's Mackerline. She wins a possession back from Emma Godfrey. That long pass rolls on through Christina Glazer, the senior who is looking to put up her second career goal. Scored once back in 2017. It's the only time she's found the back of the cage in her four-year career here at Hopkins. Here's Urbanski, and has her pass deflected down by Speary. Dombrowski tripped up there. She'll get the restart again. Remember, Maddie Dombrowski, number six on the roster, forgot her uniform on the bus to Hopkins, so she's wearing that number one jersey for Dickinson today. And she gets the takeaway. It's rolled up to Amanda Fruman. Gets through her, and now Tessa Erickson. Abby Burke. Burke has numbers towards Glazer. And bad break for Hopkins there as Burke didn't quite pass it directionally to someone. Now maybe a break for Dickinson here if they can keep it in. Long run. It's kept in now towards the goal line, and that pass is knocked down and cleared away. Avery Seward, some good defending there from the Hopkins sophomore defender. Dickinson with a couple chances, though, to try and get one in the goal here in this fourth quarter. Trailing at 4-0. Now we'll see if Hopkins can run. Game's really opened up for the last couple of minutes. Here's Erickson. Tessa Erickson up the right sideline. Spins back to her left. Tries to roll one all the way across into the circle, but that shot kicked away as Sage Stevens gets the first save of her career. Sienna Urbanski had a lot of time and space. I think just rushed that one a bit. Looking for her second goal of her career for the freshman. Sophie Kim. Burke trying to keep possession. So if the score holds and the result holds here with the 4-0 Hopkins lead, that'll make it 5 wins in a row for the Blue Jays, and those 5 victories will come at a combined score of 23-5 over the last 5 games, with 4 of those games being conference wins and the other one being a 4-2 victory over number 13 Messiah back on September 25th in what was an NCAA quarterfinal rematch. Into the circle here, chance for Dickinson, but Hall comes out to kick it away. Bridget Fontaine, the sophomore out of Massachusetts, was in on goal. And Caitlin Hall, really her first big test of the day, comes out to kick it away and keep the shutout alive with 7.5 minutes to play. So it'll be 5 in a row for Hopkins. They'll look to make it 6 in a row. Again, 12:30 Saturday right here against Muhlenberg. You can watch it here on Hop TV. The women's soccer team also takes on Muhlenberg Saturday. That's at 3:30. And the men's soccer team at 6:30. They'll play Swarthmore. It's a big week of athletics here. Volleyball at home tomorrow night. Water polo on Friday night. Couple volleyball matches Saturday as well, Hop TV. volleyball team with its best start in program history. Now 17-0 on the season, still haven't lost. Previous record was 16 wins to start a season. The Blue Jays now 17-0, moving up to number 12 in the country in the rankings. One of just two undefeated teams left in D3 volleyball. And they'll look to keep that going tomorrow night. Up the field for Bridget Fontaine. 6 minutes to play in this one. At this point for Dickinson, a win out of the question. They're just looking for a goal, trying to avoid the shutout. Some contact with Hannah Grothrusen, the sophomore, number 23 in white with the knee brace on her left leg. Hopkins trying to make it five. Corvey rolls one ahead, looking for Sam Chabot, but it was pulled down. Hopkins will get it back. Here's Corvey again. Corvey in towards the circle, deflects loose, and Stevens gets to it again. Sage Stevens with her first two saves of her career as she came in to play this fourth quarter in goal. The freshman with her first collegiate appearance. Roll it into the circle. Olivia Fox into the game. Megan Abate takes it. And it'll come back outside the circle. With under five to play now. Mackerline over to Corvey. Corvey, her drive was stopped. Sophie Kim picks it up though. Up to Megan Abate, who's into the game for the first time. Number one in blue. Sophomore out of Summit, New Jersey, has two goals on the season. But Hopkins is going to roll to this W today. And again, it was really the hot start that just put Dickinson away. Two goals in 6 minutes for Hopkins. Maddie Brown Shearer and Sadie Abood in the first quarter. And it was quickly 2-0 on their first two shots of the game. Hopkins will get three more subs in there. I think the three who haven't played yet today. Number three, the junior Caroline Ross is in there. And looks like Maddie Stabinski and Sarah Jenny both set to check in for the first time as well. And here comes Stabinski as Bryn Rowland goes to the bench. Stabinski, number 17 in blue. Senior out of Swarthmore, Pennsylvania. And now the freshman Sarah Jenny, number 35, out there. And it's like everybody on that Hopkins team, as far as field players go, have gotten into this one. Dickinson looking for one more push. Here's Bridget Fontaine. Fontaine into the circle. Fontaine just pushes it wide. One of the best chances of the day for the Red Devils, but she missed it wide to the left. And Dickinson will stay scoreless with 2.5 to play. Megan Abate. She turns it over. Here comes Makara Desai. Claire Tabin now. Oh, big stick came up into the air and very close to hitting Riley Mitchell, freshman forward out there, number 9 for Hopkins, but just missed her. Scary moment there, but Mitchell seems to be okay. Into the circle here, Dickinson with one more chance, scoots on through and just goes wide. Caitlin Hall went diving for that one, but again, Dickinson with back-to-back really good chances, and they just pushed that one wide, and it stays at 4-0. Here's Stabinski. She'll have it roll off her stick. So Dickinson will fall under 500 both overall and in the conference. Whereas Hopkins will get to 9-2. Grethrusen now, and she loses possession with under a minute to play. Hop maybe pushing for that fifth goal. Still haven't scored in this fourth quarter. Sam Chabot still pushing. Megan Abate in the area, and it rolls across the goal line. Under 20 seconds remaining, and Hopkins in no rush. They've got this win locked up. Mitchell will try to roll one in, and the referee is going to stop her, and that's going to end this one. Near from Homewood Field, full dominance from Hopkins from beginning to end, a good 60 minutes that the Blue Jays put together, and number 10 Hopkins wins it 4-0 over Dickinson and stays perfect in Centennial Conference play. The four goals today, Maddie Brown Shearer got one early, Sadie Abood followed about 3 minutes later to make it 2-0. Then just as the second quarter started, Bryn Rowland made it 3-0. And Tessa Erickson in the third quarter made it a 4-0 game. In goal, just 2 saves for Caitlin Hall. She wasn't too busy back there as the Hopkins defense had a good day, and Hopkins offensively really controlled the possession. Dickinson with the loss falls to 5-6 overall, 2-3 in the Centennial. Number 10 Hopkins now 9-2 on the season and 4-0 in conference play. Next up for Hopkins, this Saturday, 12:30 start against Muhlenberg right here at Homewood Field. And you can watch that one here on Hop TV. It is the start of a triple header on Hop TV on Saturday. Field hockey against Muhlenberg at 12:30, women's soccer against Muhlenberg at 3:30, and then men's soccer against Swarthmore at 6:30. That is again this Saturday, October 12th. So make sure to tune in all day right here on Hop TV. It's big games at Homewood Field. So one more time for our entire Hop TV crew. I'm Connor Newcomb signing off from Homewood Field for now. Hopkins with another dominant victory as they win it 4-0 over Dickinson. Hope you enjoyed this one and join us next time here on Hop TV.